Hello and welcome to Wednesday Lenten worship at Christ Concord. This is our final Wednesday Lenten service of the season. We look forward to the rest of Holy Week and to the celebration on Easter. We're glad that you are with us. Join us for our service on Thursday night at 7 o'clock in person or online, Friday at noon online, or Friday evening at 7 o'clock online or in person, and Easter morning, 8 a.m. or 10 a.m. We look forward to seeing you. For now, let's worship. Impetuous Peter. Peter, who often spoke before he fully processed, before he fully thought about what he was going to say. He asks Jesus to invite him out onto the water. He proclaims Jesus as the Messiah and really has no idea what that means. And he promises that he would never abandon Jesus, even if everyone else does, even if it means his own death. Oh, Peter, impetuous Peter. All it takes is an innocent question by a young lady standing around the fire on a cool evening, warming herself to tempt Peter to deny it all. Hey, you with the Galilean accent, weren't you one of his disciples? You were with him. It's too much of a temptation to pass by. It's the night Jesus is arrested. Let's hear what happens in Mark chapter 14. Meanwhile, Peter was in the courtyard below. One of the servant girls who worked for the high priest came by and noticed Peter warming himself at the fire. She looked at him closely and said, "You were one of those with Jesus of Nazareth." But Peter denied it. "I don't know what you're talking about," he said. And he went out into the entryway. Just then, a rooster crowed. When the servant girl saw him standing there, she began telling the others, this man is definitely one of them." But Peter denied it again. A little later, some of the other bystanders confronted Peter and said, "You must be one of them because you are a Galilean." Peter swore, "A curse on me if I'm lying. I don't know this man you're talking about." And immediately the rooster crowed a second time. Suddenly, Jesus' words flashed through Peter's mind. "Before the rooster crows twice, you will deny three times that you even know me." And he broke down and wept. Oh, Peter, impetuous Peter. The reality is how like us you are. How like us you are, Peter. It's so easy for us to sit in a Bible study, a Sunday morning worship service, in a Christian book study, or in a small group discussion and promise our eternal love to Jesus. And then, just like Peter, deny Jesus, ignore Jesus, not even think about Jesus. How do we do it? How do we deny Jesus? Oh, count the ways. We can probably think of millions. Sins we commit. Sins we omit, passing by opportunities to be Jesus to others, ignoring times that we could listen to others and then share our faith story, basically living our lives for ourselves instead of living for Jesus. That's what we hear in 2 Timothy chapter 2. "So I am willing to endure anything if it will bring salvation and eternal glory in Christ Jesus to those God has chosen." This is a trustworthy saying. If we die with him, we will also live with him. If we endure hardship, we will reign with him. If we deny him, he will deny us. Oh, Peter, impetuous Peter. How like you we are. Lord, forgive us. Lord, guide us. Let your Holy Spirit support us and encourage us to follow you always, no matter what. Amen. We join together in prayer. Gracious Lord, let the fire of your Holy Spirit come to us. Let the fire of your Holy Spirit be with us so that we may always proclaim you, Lord, that we might be with you now and always, that we would never deny you. But Lord, we know our human tendencies and we ask that you would forgive us our sins, that you would bring us back to you and direct us in ways that we can be Christ to others, that we can serve others, that we can tell your story after we listen to others' stories, that we might have you in our lives now and always, that we might serve you and deny ourselves so that we can be Christ to all the world. Be with those who are hurting, those who are struggling, all those that need your healing and hope and comfort, especially those whose names we lift to you now, aloud or in our hearts. Lord Jesus, let us never deny you, but rather live with you and for you all the days of our lives. For it's in your name that we pray. Amen. Remembering our baptism, we take a bowl of water and we make the sign of the cross on our forehead, remembering that when we were baptized, we were named and claimed as a child of yours. Remember your baptism, knowing that you were marked with the cross of Christ and sealed by the Holy Spirit forever. Let this water not only wash over you in that day of your baptism, but always, every day, every time you touch water, wash your face or wash your hands. Let you be reminded of God's cleansing action coming to you through the Holy Spirit. For those joining us in Holy Communion, now is a good time to make sure that you've got some bread and some wine available, that you could join us as we bless these elements together. In the night in which Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." We join together as our Lord teaches us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We are glad that you have been with us for this midweek Lenten journey and hope that you join us for our Maundy Thursday service at 7 o'clock, Good Friday, noon online, 7 o'clock online or in person, and Easter Sunday, 8 a.m. or 10 a.m., that special day when we celebrate the risen Christ. We're glad that you're with us. Stay connected with us. Drop us a note and let us know that you are worshiping with us and how we can stay connected with you. Go in peace, my friends. We'll see you soon. Thank you.